Yo, it's what the truth is. Anyway, what I was gonna say. Don't ever get it twisted, they ain't in my lane. Carrying my complexion, so you know I run the gang. Gangsta baby girl, so you know I spit them flames. Ay, all my bad bitches go and throw it back. And all my real bitches go and make it clap. If you looking for the party, this is where it's at. If you wanna come and party, you know where we at. We gon' keep it lit all night. Party still going through the daylight. Say you wanna taste better, act right. Say you wanna taste better, act right. We gon' keep it lit all night. Party still going through the daylight. Say you wanna taste better, act right. Say you wanna taste better, act right.
Okay, so at one point, you were working with this engineer named Arnie Frager. I'm probably messing up his name.
No, that's exactly how his name is.
Okay, who had worked with everyone. He had done number one songs with Prince and everything else like that. And I guess Prince wanted to sign the group himself.
And that's why this book, The Untold Story, is hopefully fascinating. At one point, the girls were in the room, in the studio, in Sausalito, California. Prince was in one room. Marvin Gaye was in another room. Diana Ross was in another room. I mean, this is a type of exposure that these ladies had at a very, very early age. So as I was writing the book, I said, man, this is always... What an appropriate name, Destiny's Child, because they've always had this destiny about them.
Well, I mean, I just looked it up. Marvin Gaye died in 1984.
Well, maybe it wasn't Marvin Gaye. Who else was it? Somewhere in the book we talk about, I think Arnie talks about who were all the people in the room in the beginning. Okay. I think his second interview.
Well, what happened to that Prince deal?
You know, that was before me being involved. And so I just believed that Arnie maybe didn't follow up. Prince didn't follow up, vice versa, but it never went anywhere.
Well, I guess one of their early tours, they're opening up for John B.
Can you believe that?
I just interviewed John B. I mean, I'm a fan, but, you know, when you look at John B. and Beyonce these days, it's just interesting to see the comparison.
Well, let me tell you how that came about. You know, in 2002, in 2002, I sold Music World to Sanctuary, and then I became president of Music World Sanctuary Urban, and we had artists like Chaka Khan, OJ's, Earth, Wind, and Fire, but I also signed John B. to the record label. And so John B., we had gotten a tour. And so I had all of my artists on one tour. I had Destiny's Child opening. I also managed Jagged Edge. They were the second act. And then I had John B. as the headliners. You know, that part of my life, one day we'll talk about, is as if from 2002 to 2007 don't exist in my life. When I ran one of the largest record labels, and I ran the largest urban management company in the world, and had all of these acts from D12 to Nelly to, I could go on and on and on, who was signed to our management company. I don't know what about history. It's a frightening to talk about that, but one day maybe you and I will talk about just those years. Mary J. Blige was one of our clients as well. Floor Tree was one of our clients. We had it going on then.
Well, when you say you were managing D12, were you also managing Eminem in the process? Or
No. I bought five urban management companies, and these guys were doing their day-to-day, but they reported to me.
Gotcha. Okay, so after a lot of the switch-ups in the group, Latavia and Latoya were in the group with Beyonce and Kelly. And then you talked about in the album, I'm sorry, you talked about in the book where they approached you Well, you got a letter that's saying that you will no longer be managing them, and they have their own managers.
Correct.
And that kind of created a big problem.
Well, that started really from a poor decision that I made in putting on that tour we just talked about with John B., on putting both Destiny's Child and Jagged Edge on the same tour bus. Now, remember, the girls are minors. They're minors. They're 16 years old. The guys are 21, 22 years old. I have a fiduciary duty with minors by the law. There's a certain way I have to manage that. I got a call from Kelly and Beyonce, and I talk about this in the book in detail, saying that they were constantly being harassed by two other members of Jagged Edge. And I couldn't have that. And I literally had to put the guys off the bus in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. That began all of this drama. And yes, I got an attorney call me out of the blue to tell me that I would be getting a certified letter. And he had just faxed me the letter to tell me that at this point, he was now on an interim basis managing Latavia and Latoya, and that they would finally go and search for a final manager. But for now, he was in an intern, the manager. And I told him then, I said, well, sir, how much do you know about this group? He said, very little. I said, well, do you happen to have a CD? He says, by the way, I have a CD. I said, take a look at that photo. I said, Kelly and Beyonce sing about 95% of all the music. The two people you manage sing about 5 to 10% of everything. Are you sure you want to make this decision? Are you sure you want to do this? He said, yes. I said, well, this would never work. You can't have two managers that's not on the same page. How could you even do a tour? How could you make a record? How could you even decide what you're going to wear? Where you got two people against two people. And I went to the record label, and they supported me wholeheartedly. They finally made the ultimate decision. You know, Beyonce got a black eye for it. She had nothing to do with it. I made the decision along with the record label.
Well, in the book, you talk about a conversation you had with Donny Einer, who was, I guess, was the chairman of Sony Music at the time.
And friend.
And friend. And you told him, like, look, we're having problems with these two girls. And his response was, Matthew, I don't give a shit about the other girls. As long as Beyonce and Kelly are still in the group, we're fine. You go out and get two new members, three or one. It's your decision.
If anybody knows Donny Einer, know all the energy that he put behind that when he said it. A very passionate man about music, understood groups. Understood the dynamics of it, and knew it wouldn't work. And as long as he knew, as long as he had Beyonce and Kelly, you know, he left and trusted me and my judgment on making the right decision. And so he supported that wholeheartedly. Now, this is a multi-billion-dollar decision we're talking about. Destiny's Child has generated multi-billions of dollars for Columbia and Sony. So these are major decisions, again, that 16-year-olds don't make, as you know.
Well, of course.
Some of your people that are viewing right now literally think in the music industry that Beyonce and Kelly would make a decision like this. Just goes to show you how very, very little that they know about the music industry.
Well, I just want to touch on this first. You know, before we get off this topic, is here you are, you're managing this group, but in the group is your daughter, as well as Kelly, who was, I guess, living with your family at the time?
Correct.
So, and they're, what, 17 years old? And you have these 23, 24-year-old men that are trying to sleep with your daughter? Like, how is a father, not as a manager, fiduciary responsibility, whatever. How does a father deal with this situation?
We won't talk about that on camera.
Great answer.
Slap.
Look, she like, yeah, raw nigga. Really couldn't call niggas. Wish I was a rich nigga. Y'all would never saw niggas. And then people trying to watch my ass and who involved with us. And I lost some real niggas. I can't even stall niggas. Pussy niggas dissing and then raps and rhyme with all nigga. Nah, it ain't no truce, nigga. You know you involved, nigga. And this baby G26 ain't here to taunt, nigga. Boy, I'm down to blitz niggas. And I take the charge, nigga.
Short temper, why the fuck they wanna star with us? New generation niggas poodles, ain't no hard in them. On Insta Snap, you trying to show you in that car with them. Doing all that riding dick gon' get you far, nigga. And I don't know how this bitch feel, but I know what her face say. I still do the bust down, so sandwich out a Safeway. These bitches so in love with me, I know it's only fake way. Got niggas in that dog case, surviving off of Jake Pay. And I just got these Gucci shoes, you know I'm feeling icy. Everywhere a movie scene, they think more than Spike Lee. I seen niggas post guns, and that shit don't excite me. The songs I really downplay, cause I don't like to hype me. I know you a clown, boy, the world just ain't figure yet. Fuck the one on IG, I'm looking for a bigger check. In person, you was not tough, just show it on the internet. She treat me like I'm on now, and I ain't even did it
look,
yet.
Look, she like, yeah, raw nigga. Really couldn't call niggas. Wish I was a rich nigga. Y'all would never saw niggas. And then people trying to watch my ass and who involved with us. And I lost some real niggas. I can't even stall niggas. Pussy niggas dissing and then raps and rhyme with all nigga. Nah, it ain't no truce, nigga. You know you involved, nigga. And this baby G26, I hit a tall nigga. Boy, I'm down to blitz niggas. And I take the charge, nigga. I can't show my every move. They gon' think a nigga fell off. For every bitch who love me, bitch, I hope you know I'm well off. And they can't understand me, I don't think they wanna be us. This nigga really broke, so why the fuck he got his feet up? I swear you niggas playing, when we come through, we gon' clean up. My cousin need his job, when he come through, he gon' ski up. You can lose two friends, I give a fuck if niggas three up. They send me to that Y, cause I was trying to hold my team up. Yeah. And I've been hanging with them savages. Stuffing 20s and 50s up in our mattresses. These niggas capping, they faking, these niggas actresses. I'm down to lose for my niggas, I'm on some savage shit. The suckers think we ain't tripping, can't wait to run into them. I watch my brother throw bands like it was nothing to him. This generation C10, they think it's something to him. Got tired of fucking these hoes, I just look, be running like a raw nigga. Really couldn't call niggas. Wish I was a rich nigga, y'all would never saw niggas. And then people trying to watch my ass and who involved with us. And I lost some real niggas, I can't even star niggas. Pussy niggas dissing in the raps and rhyme with all nigga. Nah, it ain't no truce, nigga. You know you involved, nigga. And this baby G26, I hit a tall nigga. Boy, I'm down to blitz niggas. And I take the charge, nigga.
Fucking slap.
Me in my day one, never a doubt, it's a fact, that's my day one. I never thought it'd come to this, now my day one. I never thought I'd see the day wasn't day one. We used to smoke together, make plans together, plop down $1 billion and stay rich forever. Ball together and laugh together. But now you got a nigga fucked up. Fucked up, fucked up, fucked up. Yeah, yeah. Fucked up, fucked up, fucked up. Checkmate, 12 on the way. They send a caravan, a knock to the estate. Escape routes, it ain't no routes for your escape. They got the blueprints and plans, they've been plotting this for days. Come get your man, he been leaking shit for months. Eating bacon turkey sandwiches with pigs over lunch. You like, not the one you stood beside when it was war. I'm like, I try to tell you, stay the fuck away from war, alright? I hope you stashed away some cash and royalties. Chase the school and cop, but more important is lawyer fees. Stick to the rules, nigga, that's how it goes. Cause this is business, and it ain't personal. We was on the same track, me and my day one. Never a doubt, it's a fact, that's my day one. I never thought it'd come to this, now my day one. I never thought I'd see the day it wasn't day one. We used to smoke together, make plans together, plop down $1 billion and stay rich forever. Ball together and laugh together. But now you got a nigga fucked up. Fucked up, fucked up, fucked up. Yeah, yeah.
Swear to God, these niggas got us fucked up.
Yeah.
The IRS is in my books, accountants told me to chill. Percy caught a murder case, guess who's footing the bill? Pistol caught three attempts, guess who's footing the bill? Now niggas get to questioning me like who's real. I was locked up, you was tapping my accounts. Came home like Fredo, nigga, you had to bounce. You was my day one, I mean the main one.